Hi, I'm Jeff.
And I'm Hanny.
Welcome to this month's Grammar Station lesson. Part A of this month's lesson is titled, Stop Bugging Me. Leave me alone. Stop bothering me. Why do you have to be so annoying?
Are you talking to me, Jeff? I haven't really said anything at all.
Oh, no. I am not talking to you, Hanny. I would never, ever be so rude to you. Earlier, I was telling you what this phrase, stop bugging me, means. Sorry for not making that clear. Maybe later, Teacher Daphne will explain things. Anyway, no, I was not talking to you, Hanny. You're A-okay.
Thanks, I guess. Okay, let's get down to business, everyone. Today, we're going to listen into a conversation between Angie and Brad. It sounds like someone will be bugging someone else.
Mm-hmm. Today, someone will be bugging, bothering, or annoying someone else. I think it will be Brad who will be bugging Angie.
You might be right. We won't know for sure, though, until we start reading from today's lesson.
Mm-hmm. Let's figure out who is bugging whom. Let's get started.
Okay, everyone. It is now time to take a break. Oh, it is also time to look over today's vocabulary. When we come back, we'll get started on this month's Grammar Station lesson.好，今天对话一开始 ，Brad 一直在踢 Angie 的椅子，而且不止一次，这让他觉得很烦。我们先来看三个单字 ，kick 是指踢或者是踹，那在课文里面是当动词。例如 ，He kicked the ball to his teammate. He kicked the ball to his teammate. 他把球踢给队友。下一个单字 ，chair 是椅子。它是名词，例如 ，Mia jumped onto the chair when she saw a cockroach on the floor. Mia jumped onto the chair when she saw a cockroach on the floor. 当 Mia 看到地板上有一只蟑螂时，她马上就跳到椅子上了。那刚刚说不止一次，我们用到的单字是 once。Once 就表示一次、一回，那它是当副词，例如。They go to the movies once a month. They go to the movies once a month. 他们一个月去看一次电影。接着 Angie 请 Brad 不要再踢了，他不会再讲第二遍。如果 Brad 再踢一次，他就要告诉老师。那么单字 again 就是再一次，它是当副词。例如 ，Don't make the same mistake again.Don't make the same mistake again. 不要再犯同样的错误咯。好，那现在看完单字例句，我们来读课文吧。
Brad keeps kicking Angie's chair.
Hey, don't do that. I'm trying to read.
Do what? I didn't do anything. I'm just reading my book too.
Yeah, right. Don't make me laugh.
Okay then. Tell me, what did I do?
Explanation 1.
Welcome back to Part A of this month's Grammar Station. Today's lesson is titled, Stop Bugging Me. Now, the characters in our dialogue are Angie and Brad. Okay? The star, though, of our show.Is Teacher Daphne.
大家好，我是 Daphne。今天的第一则文法是 stop 加 ving， 意思是停止做某事。Stop 是及物动词，意思是停止。三态是 stop, stopped, stopped。后方用动名词 ving 当受词。例如 ，We have stopped using plastic bags。我们已经停止使用塑胶袋。至于句型 ，stop to 加原形动词的 stop 是不及物动词，意思是停下来。后方用不定词 to be 说明停下来去做的事。例如 ，Oscar stopped to take a break。Oscar 停下来休息一下。
谢谢 Daphne 老师的讲解。那么今天课文标题是 Stop bugging me。别烦我。那么 bug 当名词可以指虫子，不过它在这里是当动词来表达烦扰、打扰。那我们在开场的时候用到 annoy 这个字 ，A-N-N-O-Y， annoy 它也有这种使什么烦扰、惹恼的意思。那它的现在分词 annoying 可以用来形容恼人的、很烦的、令人生气的。Okay, it is now time to get started on this month'sGrammar Station lesson. So, Angie has the first lines of our lesson.
Mm-hmm. But let's go ahead and set the scene. What's going on right now? Before Angie begins speaking, we learn that Brad is bugging Angie. Brad keeps kicking Angie's chair.
Brad is being very annoying. Angie says, Hey, don't do that. Stop kicking my chair. Can't you see that I'm trying to read?
Now next, Brad acts like he has no idea what Angie is talking about. Huh? Don't do what? He says.Boy, Brad is really annoying.
Yep, he's acting like he has no idea what Angie is talking about. He says, I didn't do anything. Me? I didn't kick your chair. That must have been someone else.
Brad is playing dumb.
It's not me.Who kicked your chair? It was someone else. Maybe it was a ghost.
Or maybe you're just imagining things, Angie. It's all in your mind. Anyways, it's official. Brad is annoying.
Right. 现在 Brad 他在装傻，他明明就一直踢 Angie 的椅子，还说他没有踢。那我们来学一下装傻的英文，就是 play dumb. And Brad has even more to say next.
I didn't do anything, he says. I'm just reading my book too.
Which is kind of funny, because let's face it,Brad is not a book reader. Just look at him.
Yeah, he looks dumb, but it's true. Brad, he wasn't reading his book. He's a bug, not a reader. And Angie knows this. She says, Yeah, right. You were reading your book. There's no way that you were reading, Brad.So, don't make me laugh. Way to go, Angie. Take care of Brad. Deal with this bug, this bothering person. Also, before I forget, let's go ahead and hear from Teacher Daphne for another grammar note.
第二则文法是 don't make me laugh. 意思是你少来了，别开玩笑了。是一句否定祈使句，句构是 don't 加原形动词 ，make 是使役动词，意思是使。如果是使后方的受词主动做某事，句型是 make 加受词加原形动词。Laugh 是不及物动词，意思是大笑。Don't make me laugh 字面意思就是别使我大笑，用于觉得对方说的话不真实，不足以采信的时候。例如 You hit the jackpot? Don't make me laugh. 你中了头奖，别开玩笑了。
And we're back. Brad is not going to give up. He's going to keep playing dumb. He's going to continue bugging poor Angie. Next, playing dumb, he says, Okay then, tell me, what did I do?Well, this question is annoying because Brad knows exactly what he was doing. He's going to make Angie play this silly, annoying game.
Gosh, Brad is annoying, isn't he? Anyway, everyone, it is now time for a break. When we come back, we'll hear some more from Brad.And Angie.
Right, so don't go away. We'll be back soon.
You kicked my chair and not just once. It's bugging me, so stop it.
Prove it. My feet were nowhere near your chair.
I won't tell you again. Stop kicking my chair or I'm going to tell the teacher.
Hey, be nice. I'm just playing with you.
Explanation 2.
Welcome back. Let's continue reading from Part A of this month's Grammar Station lesson. Before the break, Brad was playing dumb and bugging Angie. He's a real pain.
Yeah, he's a real pain. First,He wouldn't stop kicking Angie's chair. Then he acted like he had done nothing wrong. Actually, he acted like he didn't know what Angie was talking about.
Angie is getting mad, and she's going to show it. Remember, Brad asked, "What did I do?" Next, Angie answers this question.She says, You kicked my chair, and not just once, so stop playing dumb. I know you did it, and you do too. It's bugging me, so stop it.
Well, good for Angie. She's standing up for herself. Way to go.
I like how Angie is dealing with Brad. Brad, though, he is not going to quit. He's really, really annoying. Next, he says, Prove it. Prove that it was me who was kicking your chair. Then he says, My feet...We're nowhere near your chair.
Huh. Angie 请 Brad 不要再踢他的椅子，但是 Brad 他就一直装傻，还叫 Angie 拿出证明。他说他的脚根本就离 Angie 的椅子很远。那么补充单字 prove 就是证明或是证实。那么 nowhere near 字面意思是没有任何地方靠近，那就是用来表达一点也不接近，离很远的意思。Now, this Brad guy is not playing dumb anymore. He's just lying. Again, he is super annoying.
Gosh. And Angie, she has had enough. She's not going to let him keep bothering her. I won't tell you again, she says. Stop kicking my chair, or I'm going to tell the teacher. Way to go, Angie. Brad will stop now, I bet. Now that you've scared him.
Maybe so. Anyway, next, Brad says, hey, be nice. Take it easy. He's saying, you don't need to tell the teacher, Angie.
He's scared. Then, to explain himself, he says, I'm just playing with you. As though this makes everything else okay. Ugh, Brad, you are annoying. Hey, Teacher Daphne, what do you think about all of this?
第三则文法是 A plays with B, 意思是 A 和 B 开玩笑。Play 是不及物动词，意思是开玩笑，闹着玩。后方用继续词 with 引出开玩笑的对象。例如 ,Jackie is playing with his girlfriend. Jackie 在跟女朋友开玩笑。
And we're back. Thank you, Teacher Daphne.
Thanks indeed. Okay, everyone. It is now time to say goodbye because it's the end of our lesson. But there's more Grammar Station this month. We'll see you next time with more. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Part A. Stop bugging me. Brad keeps kicking Angie's chair.
Hey, don't do that. I'm trying to read.
Do what? I didn't do anything. I'm just reading my book, too.
Yeah, right. Don't make me laugh.
Okay, then.Tell me, what did I do?
You kicked my chair and not just once. It's bugging me, so stop it.
Prove it. My feet were nowhere near your chair.
I won't tell you again. Stop kicking my chair or I'm going to tell the teacher.
Hey, be nice. I'm just playing with you.
好，我是 Hanny。今天我们来学使役动词的用法。使役动词包含了 make、have 以及 let。这三个动词在此是用来表示使他人做某事，或者是让他人做某事。后面必须接受词，再接一个原形动词。那么 make、have、let 这三个使役动词的用法相同，可是它们意思有些许的差异。make 跟 have 都是叫某人做某事，不过 make 是用强迫的，尤其是叫对方做他不想做的事。Have 是赋予某个人责任，那至于 let 是指让某人做他想做的事。接着我们来学使役动词的句型吧。它的句型是主词加使役动词 make, have 或是 let 再加受词再加原形动词。例如 Ian's teacher made him stay after school. Ian 的老师要他放学留下来。用 make 可以表达出 Ian 不太想放学留下来，可是却被老师强迫留下。那要特别注意的是，受词 him 的后面必须用原形动词 stay。再看个例句 ，My parents won't let me adopt a kitten。我的父母不会让我领养一只小猫。用 let 可以表达出我想养猫，但爸妈不让我养。好，受词 me 后面必须用原形动词 adopt。接下来要介绍的是几个跟使役动词相关的用法。首先 ，get 也可以用来表达使某人做某事。意思就跟使役动词 have 是一样的，只是用法不同。 get 的受词后面必须接不定词，也就是先加 to 再加动词。例如 Susan is trying to get her husband to quit smoking. Susan 试着让她的先生戒烟，这句就等同于 Susan is trying to have her husband quit smoking. 好，那第二个要介绍的是使役动词 make 的特殊用法。使役动词 make 后面可以接形容词或是名词来作为受词的补语，它们的功能是用来修饰前面的受词。那么句型是主词加 make 或是 makes 加受词加形容词或是名词。例如 ，Your stories make the children happy。你的故事让孩子们很开心。那句子里的 happy 是用来修饰他们前面的受词 the children。再看个例句。This song made Emily a popular singer.
这首歌让 Emily 成为 一位受欢迎的歌星。句子里的 a popular singer 是用来修饰前面的受词 Emily。要请同学们特别注意，我们所学的实义动词当中，只有 make 可以接原形动词，或是形容词，或是名词。那么 let 和 have 后面只能接原形动词。最后介绍几个相关的动词，像 need 需要、want 想要、ask 要求、tell 告诉。这些动词的意思和实义动词很相近，不过用法不同。它们的受词后面必须接不定词，也就是 to 加动词。它的句型是 need 或是 want 或是 ask 或是 tell 加上受词加 to 动词。我们来看个例句 ：I need you to do me a favor。我需要你帮我一个忙。如果要表达叫某人不要做某事，那就在不定词的前面加上 not。例如 ，He told his friends not to talk while they were eating。他告诉他的朋友们吃东西时不要讲话。以上是今天的讲解，我们下次见 ，See you next time， bye。Hello， 大家好，我是 Hanny， 欢迎收看我们一分钟的单元。在这一分钟的时间里面，我们要复习四个单字，还会造四个例句。同学们准备好没？好，一分钟计时开始。第一个单字是 try， 怎么说？叫做 kick。He tried to kick the ball into the goal, but he failed. 他试着把球踢进球门 ，踢， 可是失败了。第二单字呢是椅子，椅子怎么说？叫做 chair。The chair is made of wood. 这张椅子是木质的，木头做的。第三个单字它可以表达一次、一回。这个副词啊，它叫做 once。Once, you should check your car's tire pressure once a month. 你应该一个月检查一次你车子的胎压 tire pressure. 好，第四个单字呢，它是副词，表示再一次，又再一次做了什么事。这个再一次叫做 again, again. I'll never go to that restaurant again. 我绝对不会再去那间餐厅光顾了。可恶。好，不管怎么样，我们在一分钟之内轻轻松松复习完四个单字哦。同学们表现很棒，记得要多多复习哦。那下次还要继续回来看我们哦，不可以不再光顾哦。那我们下次见，拜拜。
See you next time. Thank you.